Oh, isn't that nice? Hello, everybody. I'm Ralph DeFlorio, and this is the February 11th, 2017 edition of the New Revival Coffeehouse. And I'm color coordinated with Laura Corteses. Look at that. That's unplanned, but nice little thing that happened there. So I'm going to have Laura maybe first introduce yourself, and then the rest of the band, just if everybody can mention where you're from originally and anything else that you want to add. This is your chance to make a political statement or anything goes. We're kind of low-key here.
My name is Laura Corteses, and I grew up in San Francisco, California.
Awesome.
My name is Jenna Moynihan, and I grew up in Lakewood, New York.
My name is Valerie Thompson, and I grew up in Kansas City, Missouri.
And I'm Natalie Bohrn, and I'm from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada.
Great. Canada. So let's. I talked to Natalie a little bit before we got on mic here. So I think it might be good if I could just get a sketch of how you all came together as a band. Obviously started with you since your name's on the.
Yeah. Well, actually, in 2010, I released an album. I've had released many albums till that point, but that showcased really strings as I grew up at fiddle camp playing with other string players. And I realized that when we got together to play the songs, they sounded unique and authentic in a way that I didn't experience hearing in other bands. And around that same time, I started touring with Valerie. And then Valerie and I toured for a few years, and it was about 2 years ago that I started touring with Natalie and Jenna. And our first tour all together was in Sweden, which was pretty fun, yeah.
Why did you choose Sweden to start off?
Sweden chose us.
Yeah, exactly.
And was it what you expected? I mean, it's a place far away, and I mean...
It was far away, as expected.
It was a summertime tour, so there was a lot of daylight, which was really wonderful. And we got to meet some amazing musicians and amazing people, and
ate a lot of ice cream.
We ate a lot of ice cream.
Great. What about your musical backgrounds? I mean, have you like fiddle camps? Is that bluegrass?
No, it was actually a Scottish fiddle camp, which Scottish is where fiddle. I met Jenna.
Yeah.
Okay.
Valley of the Moon Scottish fiddling school.
Yeah.
And. That's it. Now everyone has been to this fiddle camp, but that was my start. I don't know how I ended up here, really. It's a long story. I do know how I got here.
Yeah, okay. Well, hopefully you do. That's good.
I've never been to it. Well, no, I have been to one bluegrass camp.
Yeah, so you have a really different kind of style, though, than bluegrass. This is, like, not old-timey. It's not really bluegrass. It's not really... Newgrass is, what is it? It doesn't need a label.
I was waiting for you to come up with something.
Well,
I got
a few ideas, but
to name it. But I mean, I think that's sort of what we're doing, is exploring all the places that strings can go. And you named a lot of places that strings can go and voices together. And we all have differing influences, some that overlap and some that are unique. And we try to draw on different elements of what we each love to create this sound.
Yeah.
But what were you thinking?
Well, maybe I'll answer that in a few moments. I need to think a little. I'm not really a great one at coming up. Like, I play music and I've been in bands, and the hardest thing is naming anything. Like, what's the name of your band? It's like, oh, no. But I think it's a, there's a little feel of, I've got a little bit of jazz in what I'm hearing, and certainly some classical. And the beauty of it, what I'm hearing, and I've heard your CD, I want to talk about that in a moment, is it's not an obvious genre, which is the beauty of it, because you don't kind of fit into this box, and you just are who you are, and it doesn't really need a label, I don't think. So.
I like that answer.
Okay, good. Now, let's talk about the CD that came out.
In 2013, Into the Dark.
Now, there's a different one that I was listening to.
Oh, All and Always?
All in All, yes.
Right, great. That is like a separate foray. Like, the dance cards are not on that album. It was like a little chance for me to do instrumental music, because this band has sort of become very, you know, song focused. Mm-hmm. We do a couple fiddle tunes in the show, but in general, it's about like arranging songs with strings. So I did a project called All in Always where I traveled to Spain, Sweden again, and Quebec to take fiddle tunes that I had written and that musicians there had written that were inspired by both American music and their various countries. Basically because they're the people that I get most excited about playing fiddle tunes with.
Yeah.
And to just get a chance to do that together. And so I released that, and it's all instrumental music, new compositions.
Yeah, it was. I listened to it, it was really fabulous.
Thank you.
What about the band album, though? How did that get worked out? How do you decide, for example, which songs you want, and maybe more importantly, how do you decide on arrangements?
Well, we have a bunch of ideas ourselves, but what's really cool is we have a new album that's going to get released in the fall of 2017. And the really cool thing that we did with that album is we actually worked with this great producer, Sam Kassir, who plays in the Josh Ritter band. He's produced for Lake Street Dive. And so we had a lot of ideas going into the studio, and we had a couple of songs we weren't sure if we would do or not, but it was kind of great to sort of pass that over into his territory and say, okay, what about this song? He's like, meh, we don't need it. Oh yeah, we definitely need this one. So it was a nice kind of collaboration between the things that we bring to the table, the four of us, and then also this outside viewpoint from Sam that was really great to work with.
I think sometimes you need that extra or different person that has, because sometimes you get so wrapped up in your own world that there's other ideas that might enhance it. And so if you have somebody that you can trust,
yeah,
I think that really makes a big difference.
Yeah, he was amazing to work with.
Yeah, well, cool. Regarding CDs, how do people that are watching in our worldwide audience, come on, everybody around the world has an opportunity to buy here. How do we get your CDs and other merch?
Yeah, if you go to lauracortese.net, it all becomes very obvious. Mm-hmm. I think it says shop or store. I can't remember which.
Yeah. Good. Well, I hope people do that. So if you see a big spike in traffic from around the globe, it's our audience here around the world that's looking for merch. All right. So maybe play a song to bring us
home. Yeah, we'll just finish that one we were working on. It's called Someday. It's something that's going to be off that album in 2017. If we know we were so purchase-focused, we could have done something old, but you can hear it all. Shall we keep going from where we were?
Yeah.
2, 3, 4.
Did some cross-country skiing today, which was great, great conditions. Yeah. Anybody else get out and ski? Good. Quite a few.
So this, those of you who are regulars here, I usually do a little piece of poetry, and those that like to keep score know that in the February show, I usually make it haikus, just a few things that are on my mind, nothing too heavy. Haikus, as everybody probably knows, but just to remind you that those who forgot, the form is a 5-7-5-line poem. Yes, yes, yes. What? Yes. 34-28. Just a miracle. This one's called How About That, Roger? How about that, Roger? Hand over that big old trophy. Sweet revenge, buddy. Embrace. You build walls. We'll build love. You spew hate. Our response, we will embrace. Megaphone. Megaphone. Try to shut up, Liz. Did you, boys? Well, thanks for that great big megaphone. Get me to a jam, get me to a jam. Fast, sweet old bluegrass will fix everything that's wrong. Anybody going to the Joe Val Festival this coming weekend? If you have a chance, just to cross promote for a second here, Joe Grass Bluegrass Festival is down in Framingham at the... Thank you. It's awesome. It's just great bluegrass for 3 days. Forget drugs. Hey, want to smile? Forget drugs. Just listen to Doc Watson play. All in. I'm all in with these old songs, connecting love to God, all in. And speaking about all in, I had a nice little chat with Laura Corteses and the Dance Cards, and they are really, really, really fabulous. They're just going to lift your spirits like you wouldn't believe. So welcome, Laura Corteses and Dance Cards.
First time we have had poetry for the show. Should change that. Thank you.
I can't hold the wheel, but until my true love, I can't hold the wheel.
We have Jenna Moynihan. Originally from Kansas City, Missouri, now living in the Boston area. On the cello, we have Valerie Thompson.
And rounding it out, we have our fearless leader, originally from San Francisco, California, and now she makes her home, for better or for worse, in the Boston area. We have Laura Corteses. Now what I mean by that is, like, Boston is great, but California has better weather. That's all I was saying. Especially this time of year.
For worse.
the stars, inventing constellations, fabricating time to wander in. Waited for the comet's arc, a sign the world was ending, a flash of green descending through the stars. While our lovers' backs were turned, engaged in conversation, the slightest indication of a spark. A demon and a rose, he said, the wind is ever sharper, it's cutting through the cage around my heart. California, and this next song I wrote after reading a news story about something that happened in Richmond, California, just across the bay, at a high school on the night of their homecoming dance. And when I read the news story, I just kind of couldn't believe that people could do these kinds of things to each other. And if you don't know the story I'm talking about, I'm happy to tell you after, but I'll sing you the song. It's called For Catherine. Long.
Tonight, and then also Jenna and I also have CDs of our own projects, and it's really exciting to get to do this song with all of these lovely strings and all these lovely voices every night. This fall, I had an objective. I was going to woo someone by somehow convincing them to come over to my house, and then I would play a record for them. Because I thought, like, that's like the subtle thing that one can do these days. How many of you guys have record players? See? See? Have you guys ever tried to woo someone by playing records for them?
Two honest people.
All right. That didn't work. Well, you don't have to answer that. We got a thumbs up in the back. Yeah, so, It didn't work for me, but it didn't also not work for me. He was at my house, but the record that I got that I thought was gonna be the record that would woo him, I listened to it on my own, and I was like, it's just not that good. Like, it just wasn't that good of a record.
You didn't have a plan B record.
No, I didn't have it. There is nothing woo-worthy in my record collection. I have like a Kate Bush album.
I have a plan for the spring, which is to buy you a woo-worthy record.
I've got like Kate Bush, I've got a bunch of like classical cello music, and then I have this like, no offense, Randy Newman, kind of mediocre Randy Newman live album. And I love Randy Newman. And the person of interest does as well, but alas, it didn't seem appropriate, so. Here's to the spring. And this is not exactly, but kind of what this song is about.
Thank you.
can hear every word you whisper in her ear. And I know you think that I wish that I was her, and you'd be right.
Thank you. everybody knows. So just smile and hold that stranger close. So just smile and hold that stranger close. So just smile and hold that stranger close.
Through my parents' house in a couple days, and I'm going to steal my UGG boots that I wore in high school. I'm going to put them on my feet and wear them for the rest of the tour. Anyways, okay, so this, we're gonna, do you guys like the fiddle? Sweet, safe space, okay. We're gonna play a Scottish pipe tune called Dolina Mackay. It's written by a guy named John Scott. And that's kind of it. There's not much really to say. But it is on my first and only ever album, and therefore best. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna check the tuning one more time. Smith quote,
Anyone a Patti Smith fan out there? Good. Also a safe space. Fiddles and Patti Smith, where do those two things intersect? But it was a quote in her Dream of a Life book that said, when I was a girl in New Jersey, there wasn't time for daydreaming. And I guess she was a factory worker when she was a young girl. And when I wrote this song, I had never been really to a place where kids didn't have childhood. But since then, I've traveled to quite a few places where that's the case. And in fact, to one school in Bangladesh in the middle of a slum. And the school is actually temporarily put together because the slum land is extremely expensive land. So at any moment, they could have to leave. And they might build, you know, massive hotels there. So there's a school there. And when we went to visit that school, and in this school are all these wonderful children who have dreams like becoming scientists. And at this school, they are given at least somewhat of an opportunity. And we sang this song there at this school. It's a place called the Jago Foundation. And it gave me a whole new perspective. It had just been an imagining of what it would have been like to be a child without the time to daydream. And yeah, I feel very grateful for the childhood I had. And I'm really excited to see what these kids actually do manage to create against all odds. It's called Village Green.
I was a girl on the village green. I hadn't time for daydreaming. I carried linen soft and bright. I carried secrets through the night, walking by the houses grand, hold my breath and like a statue stand to see the ones made of silk and gold as they danced on timber from the valley below. Now the dark town would sing a song, whisper low, singing for the people in the shadows. Knotted hands strung like an ox, pulling logs and stones from the lowlands to the highest hill. On my knees to scrub the floors on which they glide in the dark. I would sing a song, whisper low, singing for the people in the shadow. But for a story worth being told, pen to a page, and how I wish to sit and take in the violet smell. As the music slowed, I woke from the spell.
much. We're going to play one more and then take a little break. And I hear there's some sort of drawing or... What do you call it? What did you call it?
Door prize.
Door prize. I think that's like a raffle, right?
Yeah.
We're big fans of raffles. How do you enter this raffle?
You fill out your little ticket that you got when you came in the door.
I didn't get a ticket. No, it's okay. We have been on tour a lot of places where they have raffles, especially in Scotland. And I tend to buy as many tickets and support whatever they're supporting. And unfortunately, too many times I've actually won. And then that's really embarrassing. And so then I try to give away my raffle prize. But I don't need to do that tonight, because I'm pretty sure that it's probably one of our albums. I don't need any more of those. But we will play one more, and then if you don't win the door prize, there is a way to take the music home anyways. We have Jenna's CD woven, Val's CD, This Is Not a Love Song. And we also have Into the Dark, which we've been playing many of the songs off of on vinyl. Saw those turntable hands.
Yeah.
We also have it on CD, and every vinyl comes with a free CD because records don't do so well in the car. Or on the computer. So this is one of those songs, as many of them have been, off of Into the Dark. It's called Life is Good Blues, and if you'd sing it, that would make us very happy. It's very easy. You'll see how it's done.
We dance.